Hi there, this is Abhishek. Today I'm going to help you to troubleshoot your corrupted USB drive using CMD in Windows. So let us talk about how does your USB gets corrupted. So there may be a failure to follow the proper disconnect procedures, or maybe there is a NAND memory wear issue, or maybe the USB is not flashed properly during the flashing procedures. And how do you know your USB is corrupted? So your USB may not be recognized by the computer. As soon as you plug in, it's not listed in the file explorer. Even one more thing you can identify is that when you go into your disk management, your USB will be listed as a raw partition. So how do you tackle these issues? You need to follow the following steps in order to get your USB fixed. So the first and the foremost thing is that open your CMD. So how will you open the CMD? Everyone is aware about the Windows symbol. So you can just hover your mouse to the Windows symbol on the screen and then click on the Windows symbol, or you can see the Windows symbol listed on your keyboard. So after you're done with clicking the Windows symbol, then you will have to type in CMD from your keyboard. And then you'll be listed the following best matches in your drop up menu. So you'll see the command prompt listed above. Just hit and run as administrator in the above drop up menu. Once you select run as administrator, you will be prompted with a dialog box stating that do you want to allow this app to make changes to your device? Just ignore the message and just hit in yes. Your CMD screen will look like this. In places where the graphical user interface is not available, you can just make use of this command prompt and type in all the commands in the black and white window. Now just type in the disk part command and then hit enter. After you enter the disk part command, you will be directed towards a disk part command prompt. So here you will have to look at all the disk available in your PC. So you'll have to type in the command list disk. So it will list all the drives that you have on your PC. After you put in the list disk command, it will list the various disk available on your PC. So identify the disk which has the volume, which has the storage space of your pen drive. So here my pen drive has a 32 gigabyte storage, but actually we get 28 GB to be used. So as you can see, it's disk 2 which has 28 GB of storage. So I'll type in the command select disk 2. So in order to select my pen drive, after you have selected your pen drive, the first thing you'll have to do is to format your pen drive or clean all the partitions listed on the pen drive. So this you can do by typing in the clean command and then hit enter. Note that this will format all the data on the pen drive. So once the partitions and the pen drive is cleared, you'll have to create a new partition. So in order to create a new partition, the first thing we'll do is to type in the command create primary partition. So what it basically does, it creates a primary partition in your pen drive. So it acts as a medium of storage where you can put in your data in your pen drive. As the primary partition is created, now you will have to select that partition in order to format it. So you will have to type in the command select partition 1 in order to select the primary partition. Once you're done with the selecting the primary partition, now you will have to format it. So as soon as you create a partition, in order to get it accessible or put in the data, you'll have to format the file system. So how does that work is you'll have to put in the command format file system as FAT32, or you can format it as format fs equals to xfat. Depending on the way you want your file system to be, you can format it the way you want. So I'm going to format it as my file system as FAT32. Wait until your file system is 100% formatted. Once that is complete, it will prompt you a message that this part is successfully formatted the volume. So after that, just close the command prompt and then go into your file manager. So there you'll have to hit this PC, and there you can see your USB volume now listed, and now it is accessible. So this is the way you fix your USB drive. Thanks for your patient hearing, and have a nice day.